Once you've decided to do IVF, there are several tests that you need to have to ensure optimal IVF success. Watch this video to learn about checking the function of the ovaries. In today's episode of Infertility TV, we will cover sperm testing before IVF. Which tests are important and which ones are not? We are going to cover the uterus in a future episode. Make sure you subscribe now so you don't miss it. Test number one. The most important sperm test is the semen analysis. Does your partner have sperm? How many are there? How many are good swimmers? How many look normal under the microscope? If the semen analysis reveals the male has low sperm counts, low sperm movement, or a high percentage of abnormal appearing sperm, then your IVF embryology team should use the method called ICSI, or intracytoplasmic sperm injection, to fertilize your eggs. Without it, you increase your chances for poor fertilization or even failed fertilization. However, even if the semen analysis is normal, there is still a small chance of fertilization failure. This is why at my IVF center outside Chicago, we always use ICSI to fertilize the eggs. Test number two, DNA fragmentation tests. First, an explanation. Sperm are just very tiny transport vehicles to get the DNA from a man into a woman's egg. There is a lot of DNA and the sperm are very small, so in order to get it all in there, it has to be really packed in tight. During this process, some of the DNA strands will break. This is called DNA fragmentation. There are a number of sperm tests that measure the amount of DNA fragmentation in sperm. Are these valuable tests to get before doing IVF? I think the answer is still out. There have been a lot of studies looking at DNA fragmentation. The American Society for Reproductive Medicine issued a practice guideline which stated, DNA damage is more common in infertile men and may contribute to poor reproductive performance. However, current methods for assessing sperm DNA integrity do not reliably predict treatment outcomes and cannot be recommended routinely for clinical use. But let's say that I'm wrong, and this is a valuable test for IVF. What do you do with an abnormal result? How do you improve your chances for IVF success? Some doctors have recommended that men take antioxidants like vitamin E or CoQ10. Does that work? It doesn't seem so. A recent study found that antioxidants did not lower sperm DNA fragmentation. If you can't fix the fragmented sperm, can you separate the fragmented sperm from less fragmented sperm? Well, maybe. There are two methods of sperm selection that seem to lower the amount of fragmented sperm. The first one selects sperm that are able to bind to a chemical called hyaluronan, which is normally found around eggs. Sperm selected in this way have less DNA fragmentation. Some studies have shown better embryo development using this method, but some haven't. There is a test called the Hyaluronan Binding Assay, or HBA, that can be done before IVF. Men with a low score might be more likely to benefit from this type of sperm selection. Another technique is called microfluidic sperm separation. With this method, sperm are selected based on their ability to swim through tiny channels. The sperm that are able to do this have lower amounts of sperm fragmentation. It's a newer technique, so there isn't much research about how effective it is for improving IVF, but this one deserves to be watched in the future. There are a handful of other sperm tests that have been studied over the years, but none have emerged as a valuable addition for IVF pretesting. Our Infertility TV bottom line, a semen analysis is essential if you're going to be doing IVF. Other tests that assess for DNA fragmentation are at this point questionable, but since sperm have to be selected somehow, newer methods for sperm selection may be used instead of the traditional methods. If you like this video, remember to like this video. If you have an idea for a future episode of Infertility TV, leave it in the comments. Subscribe now. Infertility TV publishes a new episode every week. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.